Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my longer Dreamweaver course that's available on bringyourownlaptop.com. But don't worry, there's lots of free stuff here. Check out the description for the exercise file so you can play along with this tutorial. Also in the description, there'll be a link to the playlist that will show you all the stuff that is free as part of this course. All right, let's get on to the tutorial. Hey there, in this video we are going to create our site definition. We need to do this for every single brand new site that we're going to make in Dreamweaver. It's super easy. You can see it over here. I've got a folder and inside of it's got an images folder. That's all we need to do. Let's go and do that now. All right, if you're following on from the last tutorial, we're just going to close down that thing we made, okay, and we're going to set up our site. Now you need to do this at the beginning of every new site. If you're a web designer and you've got 10 different clients, you're gonna have to do this 10 different times. If you are working on your own website and you've only got one of them, you'll just have to do this once. Okay, so let's go up to site, new site, give your site a name. I'm gonna call ours Dan's Awesome Portfolio. Okay, and where we're gonna put it. The site name doesn't actually have any repercussions other than what you use in Dreamweaver to find all your files. And that's what I thought forever. Okay, I thought there's no repercussions for this. You can call it anything you like. Now I'm coming back from the future. Okay, I'm Dan from video 22. Okay, you're at video 4. And I've come back to tell you, don't put the apostrophe in because it worked fine the whole life putting anything in here, I thought. But I don't think I've ever put an apostrophe in this little site name. I'm not sure if it's a site name that has the problem or it's the folder name. One of them is the problem. Now, instead of going back and re-recording the 2 days worth of videos, which I've got with the apostrophe in here, I've just kind of come back in time to say, don't do it, don't put it in, okay? And then for the next 22 videos, you're gonna see that apostrophe and look at it and go, tut tut, Dan, don't put apostrophes in there. So stick away from any foreign keys like asterisks or ampersands, just have regular uppers and lowers, and that will not cause any problems when you get later on when we make a template. So carry on and do everything except put apostrophes in the local site folder and the site name. Okay, so back into your regular videos and I hope I don't run into my past self. Everybody seen Back to the Future? Hopefully you're not that young. Surely everybody's seen Back to the Future. All right, enough, back into it. Okay, local site folder, this is just where on your laptop this is gonna be kept. I'm gonna put mine on my desktop. Okay, I'm gonna put mine in a new folder here and I'm gonna call it Dan's Awesome Portfolio. Cool, awesome. Also, that physical name for the folder doesn't have any repercussions. Okay, some things do obviously, but that doesn't. Click choose. The last thing we wanna do in here is go to advanced settings and let's go to default images folder. Click on the little browse. You can see it's put it inside that new folder that I just made. Let's make a new folder in here and call it lowercase images. This is something specific. Okay, call it images with a lowercase I, no spaces. Let's click create, click choose. What that does is just helps us out later on when we're dragging in images from all over our computer. Dreamweaver knows where to put them. That's it, click save, and that, my friend, is all we need to do. If you can't see it, let's switch to files along the top here. If you can't see files, go to window, files, and you'll see there's my little folder. And also on my desktop, there it is there, Dan's Awesome Portfolio, and there's nothing in here except for this one folder that has images, and there's nothing in it. But just so you know, you design your site locally on your own computer first, and when you're finished, you push it up to your host, somebody like GoDaddy or Bluehost, and they will serve it to the world. All right, so that is it for setting up our site. You need to do that for every single site, and you'll see on my one here, I've got lots of sites that I work on. If you've done it wrong, you can go to site, go to manage sites, and you'll see them in here. There's Dan's Awesome Portfolio, double click it, and you can get back to that same screen. All right, let's get into the next tutorial. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, please like it and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, go to Bring Your Own Laptop for the full premium version of this course. Also, on that website is a free resources section where you can download PDFs, especially for this, the Dreamweaver cheat sheet. Okay, it's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer, and be more awesome. Bye now.